praising God together and getting encouragement throughout the middle of the week. And so I want to exalt God, beginning with 2 Corinthians 12:7. It says, to keep me from becoming conceited because of these surprisingly great revelations, there was given me a thorn in my flesh, a messenger of Satan to torment me. Verse 8. 3 times I pleaded with the Lord to take it away from me. Next verse. But he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. Therefore I will boast all the more gladly about my weaknesses so that Christ's power may rest on me. And everybody in this room right now is dealing with something. Everybody. Even if it's just small or it's great. I mean, God, we always have one little thorn in our flesh that we're dealing with so that we know that we can't do life on our own. We need God. We need him. And I want to let you know that tonight that his grace is enough. It's more than enough. Because I don't know about you, but sometimes we feel like the thing that we're battling with the most is greater than God. Isn't that crazy? How the enemy gets in your head so much that you're like, man, I don't know, God. I don't know if you can do this. I'm just going to do it on my own. Okay, what scripture I need to read? Okay, memorize. But you'd be like, man, God, I just need your grace. I just need your grace. And you just got to remind yourself that it's sufficient. It's enough. It's more than enough because Jesus Christ was an overpayment for us. Hallelujah. He was an overpayment. So I thank you, Lord, for being an overpayment for us. So just remember these few promises that his grace abounds and his name is above every name. So whatever that thorn is, you give your thorn a name, his name's above it. Remember that. Greater is he who lives in you than he who's in the world. Once again, the enemy, he's not greater. He might make you think he's greater. And like Pastor said, last Sunday he said, I used to be afraid of the devil until I remembered that he's afraid of me. Okay, so remember that. And Jesus said that we will have trouble, but take heart, he has overcome the world. So therefore, we have overcome the world. So stop trying to fix your thorn by yourself. Give it to God, because he said, cast your cares on him, for he cares for you. And the Bible also says that God desires to be generous to us, because we're his children. We, as parents, desire to be generous to our children, which brings me to the final scripture, which is Hebrews 4:16. It says, let us then approach the throne of grace. Remember that grace is sufficient enough for us. It's sufficient for us. Approach the throne of grace with confidence so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help us in our time of need. Hallelujah, may all that's for me. I thank you so much, Lord, for your amazing, amazing grace that abounds, Lord. You are so worthy to be praised, God. There is nobody else like you in all the earth. And I thank you, Lord, that we have the privilege and the honor to be called your children. And I thank you, Lord, for the Holy Spirit who testifies with our spirit that we are children of God. And I thank you, Lord, that we keep in step with that Holy Spirit who reminds us who we are. Once again, like I always say, Holy Spirit, remind us who we are when we forget. And when the devil tries to accuse us, because he's a liar, in the name of Jesus. And so, Lord, I thank you, Father, that we walk in your abundant grace that you have lavishly just poured out on us, God. And I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Father, for your hedge of protection that's around us. And I thank you, Lord, that we begin to think the right things and we cast down the lies from the adversary, Lord, in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Father, for the word that's going to come forth on tonight. I thank you, Lord, that it's going to fall on good ground in Jesus' name. Devil, you will not come and pick it up and destroy it in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord, that it's going to be embedded in our hearts. And I thank you, Father, that we're not just going to hear it, but we're going to be a doer of the word in Jesus' name. And we praise you, Father, for it. And I thank you, Holy Spirit, and we ask you to have your way. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
So mighty. Hallelujah.
How many of us know our God is big?
Yes, he is.
Amen. He is strong.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And he is mighty. Amen.
Lord.
Amen. We're going to pray right now. Amen. Ask Pastor Rita if she would come. Amen. And pray for those who are sick in their body, diseased in their body. Always get calls about people who are just overwhelmed in life and just need a prayer. So I've asked that if she would come, asked her earlier if she would come and pray for those people. Amen.
Praise God. Praise God. So important.
Thank you, Lord.
That before we go to the throne, that we ask God. You know, before I pray, I always say, Lord, just like he did before he raised Lazarus, he says, Father, I thank you that you hear me when I pray. So when we go before him, you know, we're thinking in advance that he hears us, amen? And there is nothing too hard for God. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you that you are God and you are God alone. And that there is nothing that's too hard for you, God. You do what man says is impossible, God. To you, God, it's possible, Father God. Sickness is nothing for you, Father God. We thank you right now, God. You sent your word and they were healed, Father God. You spoke, Father God, and they were healed, Father God. We thank you now, God, that we have faith in your word, God. Your word says that you are he that healeth us, Father. And we thank you now, God. We come to you now, Father, for those who are sick in their bodies who are diseased, God. We ask you now, God, to cast it down right now in Jesus' name. We come against every sickness and disease right now in the name of Jesus. By your stripes, we are healed. Every stripe you took, Father God, is for our healing, Father. We thank you that we accept the sickness from the devil, Father God, because sickness comes from the devil. We thank you now, Father God, that there's nothing, God, that you cannot do, Father God. We ask in your name, Father God. You said, we speak to the mountain, God. This mountain of cancer, this mountain of high blood pressure, this mountain of diabetes, this mountain of lead pain, Father. We speak to it now. We ask you to move in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you right now that it's gone. We thank you right now that it is gone, Father God. You said we can have, God, we ask, Father, in your name, God. So we're asking in your name, God, if there's any sick in this building, God, right now, if they would just look on you us right now, Father, thank God, just the faith of a mustard seed, Father God, and you will move, Father God. We thank you, Father God. We know that your word is true, God. Every word in from you is true, God. It's pure, Father God. We thank you right now. Satan, we come to serve you notice right now in the mighty name of Jesus. We pass every assignment that you have down right now in Jesus' name. Right now, God. Those whose minds, God, they don't know where they are, God. Touch those minds right now, God. Stir their minds, God. We know you're able to do it, Father. We thank you that you're doing it even now we speak, God. We praise you now in advance for doing it, Father. Oh, God, according to your word, Father. He said, it shall not arise a second time. He said, it won't come back, Father. We believe your word, God. We thank you. Thank you. Father God. We got to walk upright before you, Father God. So thank you, God, that we walk upright before you. So when the trials come, you let the Father God, we come to you, God, boldly, God. And we ask you what we will, Father God. We shall do it, Father God. We thank you, God, that it's all in your name, God.
Lord, I call
there, God. I'm a father. I'm a daddy, God. Show me how to be a daddy. Show me how to be a father's dad. How to be a dad, God. We don't know what to do without you, God. But we are nothing without you, God. But we know that all things are possible with you, God. That's why we can come to you right now, Lord. Oh, Lord, we come to you knowing that you hear us, God. Lord, we know you hear our prayers. Heal us right now. Heal us, God. Lord, touch our hearts and minds, oh God. Let us be led by your Spirit, oh God. Let us be sensitive to the Holy Spirit, God. In the name of Jesus. And we will walk worthy in the calling in which we have been called. In the name of Jesus. Lord, I just thank you for doing it right now, God. Lord, do what thou hast said, oh God, in the families, oh God. Lord, the wives right now, touch them, God. Lord, we are not a wife. I don't know what they go through, Lord, but you know what they go through, Lord. Lord, you know what they go through as mothers, oh God. In the name of Jesus, touch them, Lord. Touch them, Lord. Let them also be led by the Spirit, oh God. In the name of Jesus, how to be a mother. And led by the Spirit, oh, how to be a wife, oh God. That they will be a light wherever they go on their job, oh Lord. In the name of Jesus, that they will walk in their purpose, Lord. In the name of Jesus, that they will be able to raise daughters up how to be women, oh God. In the name of Jesus, touch us, Lord, as fathers, that we will raise our children up. Our sons up to be men, oh God. In the name of Jesus. And not only men and daughters, but men and daughters after your heart, oh God. Hallelujah.
Lord, we know, Lord, that you are the one that and saves in the name of Jesus. Lord, we just praise your name. Lord, we praise this community, Lord. I pray, Lord, for more town to be saved. Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that the neighborhood out there will be saved. It's your will that no one should perish.
No one.
And who are we, Lord Jesus, to not pray for the lost in Jesus' name?
But
nobody's got it all together but you, Lord. So in Jesus' name, Lord, we just pray in the name of Jesus that souls will be saved, Lord. We pray right now, Lord, in Jesus' name, that somebody woke up this morning lost, or somebody going to bed tonight saved. Lord, it's not about us, it's about you.
So Lord, I'll
make it plain in front of the whole church, Lord. Lord, send me out, go. I'll go, Lord. You've been good to me, Lord. Lord, you said that they can pray for the righteous very much. When I was in my seat, the righteous prayed for me, Lord. In Jesus' name. So Lord, I'll go, Lord. I'll pray for those who are away, Lord. Lord, you know how good you be to them, Lord. Like a prodigal son, Lord, we pray in Jesus' name, Lord, tonight, Lord, come back to me, Lord, in Jesus' name. The Bible said, come all to me, you a heavy lady. I'll give you rest.
Believing that this year that people are going to choose God, they're going to open their mouth and choose God, and that the church is going to grow, the body of Christ is going to grow all over the nation. Pastors are going to cry out to God for the congregations, and we're just going to keep praying for them all year. All year, we're going to pray for ourselves and pray for churches. Amen. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we come to you now, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
We come to you saying, Lord, create in us a clean heart, O God. The church, the body of Christ, Lord, we need you, Lord. In the days and the times and the seasons that we're living in, Lord, there's a lot going on, but Father, we're calling on you, Lord. We're calling on you to deliver, to restore, O God. Not just within the world, but within the church, Lord. We're saying, cause fresh rain to fall on us, O God. We pray that you would cause your spirit to fall again in our house, Lord. We pray for pastors on tonight, Lord, that they would seek your face, Lord, that they would seek nothing else but you, Lord, that they would be seeking your kingdom, O God, not the add-ons, O God, that we get our focus, that our eyes become upon you, Lord.
Satan, you are our help and you are our strength, oh God. I pray now that you would strengthen leaders tonight. I pray, Lord, that you would give them a word that they would hear from you, that they would speak what you are saying, not of flesh, oh God, and not what man is saying, but they speak the word of the Lord. Because we know that we live by the word of the Lord. We pray now, Lord, that you would send an anointing, send a glory, send a power in the churches, oh God. Come on, Lord, you want a lot of things that have nothing to do with you. But Father, we say forgive us. We say forgive us, oh God. Heal us, oh God. As you said, Lord, if your people, which are called by your name, you said if we would humble ourselves. Father, tonight we come humbly. We come boldly. As your word declares, say, Father, renew us, oh God. Revive us again. Revive our leaders, oh God. Revive their prayer lives, oh God. Revive their fasting life, oh God. Revive their study lives, oh God. I pray, Lord, that it be about you and nothing but you, Lord. Lord, we may ministry about a lot of things, but Lord, help us to get back to winning souls. Help us to get back to the power that was in the book of Acts, oh God. Help us to get back, Lord, to when your glory filled the house, where the anointing was so strong, where the glory was so powerful, that even your sending of God, they wouldn't even minister, because the glory had filled the house. We need the glory. We don't need another program. We don't need another message, oh God. We need your power. We need your spirit to invade our lives, oh God. We pray for pastors. We pray for their wives, oh God. Their help me, oh God. I pray that you would strengthen them, oh God. Bless their marriages, oh God, I pray. In the name of Jesus, bind them together, Lord. Let them be about the kingdom, oh God. That they're living for the kingdom. That they're declaring the kingdom. That they're speaking for the kingdom, oh God. We pray in Jesus' name. Look on the members, oh God. Look on people everywhere, oh God. All over the world, all over everywhere, Jesus. Father, we need you, Lord. Cause leaders to rise that will speak your word with boldness, that will declare that you are God, and there is none other. That will declare that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life, and no man can come to the Father but through Jesus Christ. That it's only for you that men will be saved. Your name will be on our hands. And we declare, Lord, we know that every knee will bow, every tongue will confess that you are still Lord. You're the Lord of America. You're the Lord of our churches, oh God. You are, Lord. This is your house. You tell us what to do, Lord. You have your way, Lord. We welcome you back in our sanctuaries. We welcome you back in our temples, oh God. We say, fill us, oh God. With you, Lord. Give us a hunger and thirst. Your word declares that he that hunger and thirst after righteousness, you said we'd be filled. Father, we say, fill our pastors. Fill our leaders, oh God. Fill our ministers. Fill our evangelists, Lord. Fill our teachers, oh God. We need you, oh God. We can't do this without you. If we won't be able to try to do it in our own strength, we would fail, oh God. We pray, Lord, let us be led by your spirit, Lord. Let pastors be led by your spirit, oh God. Oh God, I pray, let ministers be led by your spirit. Let evangelists, teachers be led by your spirit. Even prophets, cause them to speak the word that comes from you, Lord, and not the word of man. Oh God, we pray now that you would consecrate us, oh God, that you would sanctify us again for your glory, Lord. For your glory, Lord. For your glory, Lord. That you would give the glory. That you would be magnified. That you would be praised, oh God. Renew strength, oh God. We pray now even for those who've been in ministry, who feel that they're tired, those who want to quit, those who want to give up. Father, I pray now that you would speak to their hearts, that you would speak to their spirit, that you would lift up that hung down hell. You said you are the lifter of our head, oh God. I pray, Lord, that you would renew their strength, renew their youth like the eagles, oh God, I pray. Your word is as a day that went upon the Lord. You said you would renew their strength, go walk and not faint. We thank you that they're running, not be weary, Lord. We thank you that you said, don't be weary, well, you in due season. You said, don't reap, oh God, their harvest, Lord. I pray that you would cause them to reap joy. You would cause them to reap love. You would cause them to reap peace, oh God. In the name of Jesus, bring love back into the house. Where we love each other. Where we treat each other well, oh God, with the love of God. And that we bring that love, and we bring that power, and we bring that spirit that is in the house, the Holy Spirit. that we would take out these doors wherever we go, Lord, that we would be examples of Jesus Christ everywhere we go. That people don't have to guess that we've been with you, Lord, but we'll be like those men in Acts when they said that they realized that these men had been with Jesus. Father, we want to be with you, Lord, more than anything. Our hearts, our minds, we want to be with you, Lord. Our spirits, we want to be with you. We need you, Lord. We need your presence, oh God. Help us, oh God, even when we fall to the pray, even when we fall to the fast, to seek your face, to study your word. Create in us a hunger. Even if we've lost it, Lord, create a desire in us to get in your word, to pray, Lord, to crucify this flesh. We know that flesh can't glory in your presence. We know flesh don't want to pray. We know flesh doesn't want to get into your word. But Father, we pray now that you would revive, that you would refresh, that you would make us whole, Lord. You will cause us to be hungry for the things of God, but that we would serve you with everything in us, oh God. We pray in the name of Jesus that we will live a life that honors and pleases you. We give you praise now that you're raising up leaders, that you're raising up pastors who are going to be about you, Lord, and about your business, oh God, as Jesus was about the Father's business. We give you praise and honor and glory. And Lord, we know that you hear us when we pray, and so we thank you that it's all ready and done. Greater than the former. So we thank you for sending rain, thinking that you'll send great glory and great power in the sanctuary, oh God, because we're calling on you. And you said, he that calleth upon the Lord shall be saved, and that you will deliver. And so we thank you now. And we give you praise, and we give you honor, and we give you glory. It's in your name. The name that saves, the name that heals the world.
Somebody, amen. Touch somebody. Hallelujah. Amen. Just whoever you're touching, just briefly, just begin to pray for them. Begin to say something to God. God, if you open your mouth and you begin, the Holy Spirit will lead you down the path you need to go for that person. Just thank God for them. Thank you, Lord, for meeting their needs. Thank you, God, for bringing them here tonight that they could be in your presence, dear God, for we are in your presence. For where we are, you are also, Lord. God, we come, dear God, just as we are, Lord. Just some are broken, some are heavy. Some are in need, Lord. Some are confused. But we come, Lord. Just come to be in your presence, God. We thank you, Lord, for dwelling here with us, speaking to us, showing us love through others, God. Oh, Lord, meet the needs. Meet the needs of those who came in on tonight, Lord. We lay every need at your feet. Cast every care upon you, Lord. Because we know you care for us. We just give you thanks. Just glorify your name, Lord. You always make a way. You always come through for us. You always do those things, dear God, that we simply don't know how we're going to get done. Thank you, Lord, for your strength and your might. Thank you, Lord, always making a way. Thank you, Lord, giving us strength not to give up, not to let go of your hand.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Flowing in this place. Amen. Hallelujah. And you are blessed. Amen. Amen. Say this with me. Say, I am blessed.
I am blessed.
Amen. Say, God has blessed me.
God has blessed me.
Now you ought to say it like you mean it. God has blessed me.
God has blessed me.
Amen. I am a witness. I am a witness, church. I stand before you as a witness of the goodness of God and the faithfulness of God, that if you ask him to do something, no matter what it is, if you take your eyes off of your own efforts and your own human ability, if you just say, I'm not going to do anything but trust God on this, I don't care how big it is. Matter of fact, God specializes in you giving him the big things. You don't want the things that you can do on your own. If you can do them, why bring them to God? God said, bring me that stuff you can't do. The stuff that'll make you pull your hair out your head. That's what he wants you to bring him.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
He wants us to bring it to him and just trust him. I tell you, he'll work it out. You can pray about it as long as you want to pray about it. And while you're praying, it'll seem like God's not moving on it. Because there's always something that you have to do. You can pray and do nothing and you'll get nothing. There is always, no matter what it is you're praying about, there is something that you have got to initiate. Whether you write the plan down, write the vision down, write what you want done, it's something that you have got to do. Just praying is not an act of faith. An act of faith is after you pray, you begin to move in a direction that you're expecting God to do something. And when you begin to move, you'll see him opening doors. You'll see him doing things. Praise God. He'll do things that you can't even imagine. My God. Hallelujah. My God. Amen. Have a word from the Lord for you tonight. Amen.